Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today our topic is normal microbial flora. In this video, we will discuss all about the normal flora. So, without any further ado, let's get started. So, here we have the normal microbial flora. What is the definition of the normal microbial flora? The community of microorganisms in or outside of the human body is known as normal microbial flora. Now let's move to the microorganisms of the normal flora. What are the microorganisms of the normal flora? It includes bacteria, fungi or parasites. And what is the relationship of the microorganisms to the human body? It includes symbionts, commensals or opportunists. Now let's discuss one by one. First we have the symbionts. What does it mean? It means both organisms get benefits or mutually beneficial. For example, in our enteric tract we have E. coli that produce the vitamin K or the vitamin B complex, but in return we provide warm, moist, nutrient-rich environment to the E. coli. And what is the function of the vitamin K? It helps in the blood clotting. And what is the function of the vitamin B? Remember, it helps in the metabolism. Second, we have the commensals. And what does it mean? It means the one organism gets benefit, but the other is neither helped nor harmed. For example, Staphylococcus on the skin neither gets benefit nor is harmed. Now, let's move to the last, that is opportunist. And what does it mean? Under the normal condition, these microbes does not cause the disease, but if a suitable opportunity arises, as the name shows, opportunist, so when the suitable opportunity arises, they become pathogenic and cause disease. And what is the example of the opportunist? For example, in our enteric tract, we have E. coli. E. coli that is normally present in our digestive tract and it does not cause any disease. But when it gets into the urinary tract, they become pathogenic and cause disease. Let's move to the next topic, that is types of normal flora. How many types of normal flora? We have two types of normal flora. First, that is resident flora, and the second we have the transient flora. And what is the difference between these two flora? Let's move. First, we have the resident flora that are always present in our body and they acquire rapidly during and after the birth. So, and what is the transient flora? It means they live in or on your body for a short period of time, such as hours, days, weeks or a minute. After that they move or die off. Why they can't persist after a long time? Here we have some reason. Because of these reasons, they can't persist for a long period of time. First, competition from other microorganisms. Second, the elimination by the body's defense cells. Third, chemical or the physical changes in our body. So here we have these reasons. Because of these reasons, they can't persist for a long period of time. And after the short period, they move or die off. So here we have the sites and the related microorganisms of the normal flora. First we have the respiratory tract, second we have intestinal tract, third we have genitourinary tract, and the last we have in the skin. So let's discuss one by one. In the respiratory tract, these normal floras are present in nose, mouth and throat. In the nose, the normal floras are Streptococcus aureus and Cornibacterium. In the mouth we have Streptococcus viridans. In the throat we also have Streptococcus viridans. Now let's move to the intestinal tract. In the intestinal tract they are present in the small intestine or in the colon. In the small intestine we have the Streptococci, yeast and Lactobacilli. In the colon we have E. coli, bacteroids and clostridium. Last, we have the genitourinary tract. They are present in the urethra or the vagina. In the urethra, we have Staphylococcus epidermidis, Corynebacterium. In the vagina, we have Lactobacillus, E. coli, and the various Streptococci. In the skin, we also have some normal floras like Staphylococcus aureus, Staphylococcus epidermidis, Corynebacterium, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and the yeast. Here I want to mention some point. In a healthy human, the internal tissues such as the blood, CSF, and the urine, these are already sterile tissues. So in these sites, they are normally free of microorganisms. So in these sites, we don't have any normal floras because these are already sterile. We know that these normal floras are present in our body. So these have also some negative side, but also have some positive aspects to the human health. So here we have the beneficial role and the harmful role of these normal floras. First, we have the beneficial role. They are benefit for the protective host defense mechanism, and they will also produce the vitamins in our intestine, like E. coli. They will produce the vitamin K or the vitamin B complex that are helpful in the blood clotting or the metabolism. They have also some negative aspects, and in the immunocompromised individuals, they can cause disease. Or when they get changed their usual anatomic location, they will cause disease and will become pathogenic. So in the last, I have also a mnemonic for all the normal floras. Please ignore my little normal flora, it looks funny. So let's start. Here we have a mnemonic of important microorganisms of normal floras, and this is a flora guy or a girl. Here we have a nose. It looks like A. So in the nose, we have Streptococcus aureus, that is normal flora. Now let's move to the mouth, and the teeth looks like V shape. So in the mouth, we have Streptococcus viridans. Now this flora guy needs some body, so it looks like E shape. So in the colon, we have E. coli, and it needs some hands like S shape or an E shape. So in the skin, we have the Staphylococcus epidermidis. As this is a flora girl also, so here we have a vagina, and in the vagina we have a lactobacillus. So these are all the important organisms of the normal flora. In this video, we have discussed definition of the normal flora, microorganisms, some major sites and their respective organisms, types, harmful and the beneficial effects of the normal flora. And in the last, we have discussed the mnemonic for all the normal floras. If you like this video, so please don't forget to subscribe and share our channel. Thank you and take care.